Hi, I'm Hannah Norton, a reference and liaison librarian at the University of Florida Health Science Center Libraries. This video is the last in a four-part series that addresses formulating a clinical question and developing tactics for an optimized literature search. We've already talked about formulating a PICO question, controlled vocabularies, and search strategies. This video covers how to put all that into practice in PubMed. So why would we want to use PubMed in the first place? PubMed is the premier U.S. database of biomedical and health-related literature, including over 26 million article abstracts on topics across medicine, preclinical research, and the health professions. PubMed is freely available from the National Library of Medicine, part of the National Institutes of Health, so it will be accessible to you wherever you are in the future. While PubMed itself only includes the abstracts of articles, it provides links to the full text from a variety of different platforms. To access the full text of articles in journals that UF has subscribed to, follow the Find It at UF links in PubMed. These will show up when you go to PubMed from the Health Science Center Library's databases page. As you'll recall, in our previous videos, we identified the following search as relevant to our clinical scenario. In pregnant breast cancer patients, does chemotherapy compare favorably to surgery with radiation therapy in improving health outcomes for mother and baby? Using our PICO model, we identified five parts to that question: breast cancer and pregnancy, which represent the patient or population, chemotherapy, the intervention, surgery with radiation therapy, the comparison, and outcomes for mother and baby. Let's go into PubMed to see what we can find on this topic. From the Health Science Center Library homepage, follow the Databases quick link and choose PubMed from the list at the top of our most frequently used databases. Let's search each of our concepts separately in PubMed. First, let's search on the concept of breast cancer, starting out with how to get to MeSH terms from within PubMed. You can get to the MeSH database using the drop-down next to the search box, or from the More Resources section of the PubMed homepage. If we search for breast cancer, we find the MeSH term breast neoplasms. Click on the term to find out more about it. Under the term, there's a scope note telling us to use this term for tumors or cancer of the human breast. That helps us confirm that this is the correct term to use. We could choose a subheading, such as therapy, to combine with this term, or restrict it to a MeSH major topic, but this time we'll just use the basic MeSH term. We can add it to the PubMed search builder using the button on the right. We can then add the other keywords or phrases we brainstormed, connecting them with OR. And then send the search to PubMed. You can see under Advanced Search that this search is now saved as part of our search history, and we'll be able to combine it in a minute with searches for our other concepts. Now we can do a search for each of the other concepts in our question using the keywords and MeSH terms we brainstormed in the previous video. First, pregnancy. Then chemotherapy. Then surgery with radiation therapy. And finally, our outcomes. If we go back into advanced search, we can combine each of our separate searches into one search by adding them to the search builder. This automatically adds them with AND. We get back 135 results. We may want to narrow these results down a little bit, and we can use any of the filters on the left-hand side. There are also additional filters in PubMed that aren't automatically shown. We could choose language, and then limit to only English language articles, bringing down our results a little bit to get a more refined set of results. For additional help with PubMed, the PubMed tutorial walks you through further details of building your search, managing results, saving searches, and getting the articles. There are also a series of quick tours on specific tasks, webcasts, videos, and handouts available from the National Library of Medicine at the second link. As always, please feel free to contact the library if you have any questions, either using our general contact information or by getting in touch with your liaison librarian directly, listed by class on our liaisons page. For more resources on evidence-based medicine and more, see our guide, UF Information Resources for Medical Students.